Guys, in our last video, we shared the part 1 of Hitler's biography. Now, in this video, we will share the second part of the Hitler's biography. Hi friends, welcome to our channel, AGT Videos. Kindly please use your headphones for better experience. Rise to power. With the outbreak of World Depression in the 1930s, the fortunes of Hitler's movement rose rapidly. In the elections of September 1930, the Nazis polled almost 6.5 million votes and the party had gained popularity in Germany. In November 1932, President Edenberg reluctantly called Hitler to the chancellorship to head a coalition government of Nazis, conservative German nationalists and several prominent independents. The first 2 years in office were almost wholly dedicated to balancing power. With several important Nazis in key positions and Hitler's military, Ali Werner von Blomberg in the defense minister, he quickly gained partial control. Hitler rapidly eliminated his political rivals and brought all levels of government and major political institutions under his control. The death of President Edenberg in August 1934 cleared the way for Hitler to remove the title of president. By doing this, Hitler officially became all-powered ruler of Germany and thereby head of state as well as commander-in-chief of the armed force. Joseph Goebbels' extensive propaganda machine and Heinrich Himmler's police system perfected the complete control of Germany. Likewise, Hitler's rule was demonstrated most impressively in the great Nazi mass rally of 1934 in Nuremberg, Germany, where millions marched in unison and saluted Hitler's theatrical appeals. Preparation of war. Once internal control was assured, Hitler began mobilizing Germany's resources for military conquest, the racial domination of Central Eastern Europe. He put Germany's 6 million unemployed to work to prepare the nation of war. Hitler's propaganda mercilessly attacked the Jews, whom Hitler associated with all internal and external problems in Germany. Most horrifying was Hitler's installment of the final solution of imprisoning and eventually destroying all Jewish men, women and children in Himmler's concentration camps. Foreign relations were similarly directed towards preparation of war. The empowerment of Germany's military position and the strong allies set the stage of World War to Germany, added Austria and the Germany-speaking Sudetenland of Czechoslovakia only to occupy all the early in 1913. Finally, through 3 years of promises of territory, Hitler was able to gain the neutrality of Soviet Union, the former nation that was made up of Russia and other smaller states. Alliances with Italy and Japan followed. The war. On September 1, 1939, Hitler began World War II with his quest to control Europe. The sudden invasion of Poland was immediately followed by the destroying of Jews and the Polish allied and the beginnings of German colonization. Following the declaration of war by France and England, Hitler temporarily turned his military mission west, where the light mobile attacks of the German forces quickly dwindled. In April 1940, Denmark surrendered, soon followed by Norway. In May and June, the rapidly advancing tank forces defeated France and the Low Countries. In the air battle of Britain, England sustained heavy damage but held out of German naval operation collapsed. The major goals of Hitler's conquest lay in the east on June 22, 1941. The German army advanced on the Russia in so-called Operation Barbarossa, which Hitler regarded as Germany's final struggle for existence and living space and for the creation of the new order of German racial domination. However, after initial rapid advances, the Germany troops were stopped by the severe Russian winter and failed to reach any of their three major goals, Leningrad, Moscow and Stalingrad. The following years, advances were gained slower than expected, and with the first major setback at Stalingrad, 1943, the long retreat from Russia began. A year later, the Western Allied forces of America, England and Russia started advancing on Germany. German defeat. With the German war effort collapsing, Hitler withdrew almost entirely from the public. His orders became increasingly erratic, and he refused to listen to advising from his military counselors. He dreamed of miracle bombs and suspected betrayal everywhere. Under the slogan of total victory or total ruin, the entire German nation, from young boys to old men, often barely equipped or trained, was mobilized and sent to the front. After an unsuccessful assassination attempt on July 20, 1944 by a group of former leading politicians and military men, Hitler's region of terror further tightened. In the last days of the Nazi rule with the Russian troops in the suburbs of Berlin, Hitler entered into a last stage of depression and is in his underground bunker in Berlin. He ordered Germany destroyed, believing it was not worthy of him. Expelled his trust, Heinrich Himmler and Hermann Göring from the party and made a last theatrical appeal to the German nation. Adolf Hitler committed suicide on April 30, 1945, leaving behind a legacy of evil and terror unequaled by a leader in the modern world. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you like it.